everybody. It is, let us see, not even 2 a.m. yet. Oh, just past 2 a.m. to the T. I'm joining my father here on the 10 East. Transition from the 5 South. I got a call I've never seen before, which is odd. You figure I'd seen it all, but I don't even think my dad's seen this. Came in as a set of doubles, and it's a landscaping trailer carrying boxes, like crates of plants. Plants and grass, I think. The pictures looked weird. You'll see right now. Let me just get past this little barrier, and we'll check it out on how to best tackle this. Someone's got to move. Oh, that's cool. Good morning, Dad. Hello. That's my Red Bull. All right. Right now, that the pinhook hook is under super amount of pressure, so we're trying to split it. I told my dad, let me just use Hulk, rotate the boom over the front, and I'll pull on it while he pushes it. It'll look cool, it'll be a lot safer. We'll get it split, and then while split, we'll just flip it right here. Get that out of the way. But yeah, these crates, they have like grass and plants. It's quite a few of them. So I think we have a forklift in route with the land on. We're definitely gonna need that. that did not work. It is way too wedged in there. Nasty status. So I got a plan. I'm gonna use big flipper really quick. Drop it, please.
Yeah. coming?
Show you my handiwork, how well that worked. That's all solid. I had to use some various Milwaukee tools to get that. Look, it's still stuck in there. That's the other piece. On this one, like the unlike the set of doubles I did a couple months back, there's no danger of this recoiling because it's already on the floor and upside down, and my dad had a chain on it right here. Yes, I'll grab you one. Now we're gonna do the upright on the trailer. Okay, so this part right here. And the other side's a catch. It would be a textbook lift and catch. And it should be easy because it's just an empty trailer. Bridge height's good. what we call unicorn mode. My dad's gonna be, this is how he moves this out of the way without an underlift, using big flipper. Our version of walking the dog. It's quite simple, actually. You just boom out enough and keep enough tension so that it's impossible for this thing to swing into the back of the truck, and there's no real reason it can get away from you. This is just for an emergency, obviously. We're not gonna go across the state with this. This is just to get it out of the way. All under a bridge, too, our specialty. That's good. Alright. Now the easy part, see? So he breaks and nothing happens to this. So we'll get rid of my airline. A little too literal. And now it stays put here while we finish the rest of the job back there. Step one of many, complete. Alright. So my dad's gonna set a big flipper underneath the bridge. Very risky move, but if you're familiar with the channel, you know we're, I wouldn't say used to this, but we kind of more or less know what to do. These boxes already became separated, so there's really no salvaging this load, which is sad. And there's no easy lift points, even with the forklift, because the rails are on the other side. So it is what it is. The straps are already cut down there, as you can see, so I'm gonna set up Hulk to help my dad, and we're gonna bring it over under the bridge. So to save battery and all that, I'm gonna get back to you guys once we're rigged. This isn't the plan I wanted. It's my dad's plan, but it looks cool. Got the auxiliary lines to the outriggers, low sheaving it. I'm gonna catch there. Sometimes a simpler method is a better method. I wanted something fancy, but now time to set up Hulk while he does his catches. By the way, I haven't got this part yet, but my guys are kicking some serious butt with these boxes. They already got a handful on the land all. We got the forklift out here. I got Echo and Vicente. Good morning, Echo. What's up, Genty? So let's move Hulk now. This is pretty crazy. It's very risky. I'm gonna be doing it towards the front of my cab off the side because of the bridge. I need height to bring it over. I can't do that at 15'2". So luckily a lot of these boxes are already off. So what I'll do, it'll be coming over almost empty. Should be no problem. First is I gotta attach to the rear, lift it up so I can get my rigging equipment underneath.
hard to see that strap is holding you. That's the problem. There you go, there you go. If you have to look, just don't hold on, son.
Joe, get up there with him.
Hey, baby!
You should just come here.
Wow.
Well, I must say that was a clutch job, given the circumstances. I guess this stuff's very expensive. The guy said if we can salvage any of the load, so I left those straps on in the middle, knowing we'd be able to flip it with it and the one in the front. The other ones were completely done. There was no way to restrap them. They were done, ripped. So I said I could bring it up with these two stacks and the one in the front, and I did it. They're all my dad's. All that chain goes to Big Flipper. I don't know if you guys can see just how cramped we are. Yeah, maybe you can see it better here. We had to hop the curb. I mean, this is the beauty of the rotator, man. I keep telling you guys. A job that absolutely could be done with wreckers like this, but in less than, you know, a third of the time. Super efficient. Oh, Jacob's gonna hook up and he'll be out of here in no time. And I'm gonna just put Hulk away in the back. And my guy should be almost done with the land all on the other load. I thought this job would take many more hours from when I first showed up, and so now just comes putting away my truck. You guys see how that last load right there is what held us over. I wanted to pull my auxiliary cable, spike it in the rear, but all I really had to do was just extend out and mess with the rotation and get it to break. And it did come over. I got Vicente and Echo kicking butt on this one, man. A lot of labor on this job. Land all back there. Let me put this GoPro away. Finish putting away Hulk. What is going on, Chente? You're a recovery guy now? No rotator needed. Look at Chente. Not bad. That was cool. I got Hulk put away, Big Flippers put away. Just need to put away those. And see if I can get a second forklift out here ASAP. Quick thinking on how to bring this over. I just get my chains out. What do you think of my deal, son? Gotta admit, mine would have worked as well, but yours worked a little faster. Where is it? Thing is jacked up, but now as he comes out, you can see how little room we had to work with and how deep this bridge was. and I was going to cut that last strap, it would have made it a lot easier to come up for sure, but I'm glad we did that. We saved room. And then Joe's gonna take care of the first trailer that we flipped. Mr. Popular, Mr. Joe. Putting some of these boxes on Joe's trailer. We put a few on the one Jacob is doing. They're just getting the straps. I threw a few of my blue ones up there. We'll be clearing this road in no time. Shoot, this part takes longer than the actual recovery. But I mean, look at that. We're kicking butt. We got like three left. You're sweating, Joe. So he's actually gonna put it on the other side of Joe's chain. That chain is there so he can chain bind the axle, as you can see this, so it won't turn. That would be easier when Joe drops. Much better. Drop it. Perfect. I'm gonna go help the guys in the back sweep. Alright guys, what a night. One of those jobs where the cleanup took longer than the actual recovery, and the recovery was hard. And Joel's just gonna pull forward so we can get some flatbeds out of the way. But we're done with the cleanup job. We're able to load as much as we could on the land all, and the guys' two trailers, taking it all back to the yard for now. We did a fantastic job sweeping up and cleaning. I have to bring in an extra couple guys for that, just so we can do this a lot faster, but we are done. Joe's just gonna throw two more straps over these, because these guys' red ones are all junk. Too stressed out in red, so we're using our own. And then we're out of here. Peace out, y'all.